Welcome everyone, and today we are going to discuss about Lagrange's linear equations from the first order partial differential equations. So in this we are going to learn about the equation form, its solution methods and how to solve few problems of Lagrange's linear equations. So here is the definition: a linear partial differential equation of order 1, it should be of order 1, involving a dependent variable and two independent variables x comma y of the form capital P into small p plus capital Q into small q is equal to R. So this is a linear partial differential equation of order 1, so in which one dependent variable and two independent variables are involved. It is very clear that independent variables are x comma y and one independent variable is nothing but z. So any equation which is of the form capital P into small p plus capital Q into small q is equal to R is a Lagrange's linear differential equation, where P, Q and R are the functions of x comma y comma z, is called the Lagrange's linear equation. So how to solve these form? So if the question is of the form capital P into small P into capital Q into small q is equal to R, so we have to take it in the form that so dx by capital P is equal to dy by capital Q is equal to dz by capital R. So we have to consider these as 1, 2 and 3 equations. So in general we'll equate 2 equations and solve. On solving, on finding the solution we get. So on solving 1, 2 and 3 equations, on solving 1, 2 and 3 equations we'll get a solution. We'll get solutions as u comma v. Therefore the general solution can be written as f of u comma v is equal to 0, or a function phi of u comma v is equal to 0. So this is so simple that the Lagrange's linear differential equation, any equation of the form capital P into small p plus capital Q into small q is equal to R, is a Lagrange's linear differential equation in which two independent variables and one dependent variable is involved. So what is the working rule for it? Whenever you find this type of problem, we have to transform it into dx by capital P is equal to dy by capital Q is equal to dz by capital R. So R from here, Q from here and P from here, we have to write in this equation. And so after solving these equations, I'll show you how to solve. So on solving these two equations, so we'll get the solutions. Let it be u comma v. So the general solution can be written as the function of u comma v is equal to 0, or phi of u comma v is equal to 0. So this is one kind of solution. So whereas in my next video I'll upload the second model solution for solving the Lagrange's linear equation using multipliers, and don't miss it. So this model I'll solve few problems for you. So you have to identify, so you have to solve this equation. So we have to solve this Lagrange's linear equation as a small p plus small q is equal to 1. So solution, so this is of the form, if you observe carefully, so the equation of the form capital P into small p plus capital Q into small q is equal to R. If you compare with this, so after comparing, you can take capital P as 1 and capital Q as 1 and capital R as 1. So how we have to write? We have to write as dx by P is equal to dy by Q is equal to dz by R. So how we have to write? So dx by 1, dy by, again Q is 1 and dz by R is also 1. So here are three equations. So this is 1, 2 and 3. If I equate 1 and 2 and 2 and 3, what will happen? See, So if I equate these two equations, dx is equal to dy, and here if I equate, dy is equal to dz, and after integrating on both sides, then integral 1 dx is nothing but x, and this is 1 dy is nothing but y plus c1, and here integral 1 dy is y and z plus c2. So this will be x minus y is equal to c1, here y minus z is equal to c2. Then the general solution can be written as phi of x minus y, this is y minus z is equal to 0. So this is the working rule. So the question is of the form small p plus capital Q is equal to 1. So quickly we have to identify that. It is of the form capital P into small p plus capital Q into small q is equal to R, which is nothing but the Lagrange's linear equation. So immediately we have to transform that equation into this form, and we have to substitute P, Q, R values here, and we have to equate these two equations and solve. So after equating, I got the solution, the first solution as x minus y and the second solution as y minus z. So the question, the general solution, we have to write in the form phi of x minus y comma y minus z is equal to 0. So this is how we have to solve. And let's solve the another form. So again, if you see, so there are two independent variables and one dependent variable, and this is of the form capital P into small p plus capital Q into small q is equal to R. If you compare, so if I start writing the solution, start solving it, so this, there are two independent variables and one dependent variable, and the question is of this form. So when I compare, so in place of capital P, I have X. In place of capital Q, I have Y. And in case of capital R, I have Z. So immediately I have to identify that it's a Lagrange's linear equation, and I have to transform it in the form dx by P is equal to dy by Q is equal to dz by R. If I substitute, then it will be dx by X is equal to dy by y is equal to dz by z. So our three questions, so three equations are ready, so we have to solve. So first I'll equate these three equations, equation 1 and equation 2, and later I'll equate 2 and 3 equations. So what is equation 1 here? Equation 1 is nothing but dx by x, and equation 2 is nothing but dy by y. So here what is the equation 2? It is dy by y, and this is dz by z. So after integrating on both sides, dx by x is equal to dy by y, and here also integrating on both sides. So integral 1 by x is nothing but log x. So here also log y, some log c1. Here 1 by y dy is nothing but log y. 1 by z dz is nothing but log z plus some log c2. So if I bring to one side, then log x minus log y is equal to log c1, and here also log y minus log z is equal to log c2. How I can write this? Log a minus log b is nothing but log a by b is equal to log c1. Here also log y by z is equal to log c2. Here the solution is x by y is equal to c1, and here y by z is equal to c2. So my final answer, the general solution will be phi of u comma v is equal to some constant, that is phi of x by y comma y by z is equal to some constant. So this is how we have to solve and write these equations. So this is very easy. So we have to check whether there are two independent variables and one dependent variables, and the question is of the form capital P into small p plus capital Q into small q is equal to R. So immediately we have to identify that this is Lagrange's linear equation, and we have to transform this equation of dx by p plus dy by q is equal to dz by r. We have to substitute p, q, r values, and after equating 1, 2 equations and 2, 3 equations and solving, I got the two solutions. The first solution is x by y is equal to c1, and later the second solution is y by z is equal to c2. So my general solution is phi of x by y minus y by z is equal to c. So this is how I have solved using a solution method. So if you see this, we have to solve the partial differential equation. So in this, so again, this is of the form capital P into small p plus capital Q into small q is equal to R. When the question is of this type, so what is our capital P value? It is nothing but root x. Capital Q value is nothing but root y, and R value is nothing but root z. So after taking P, Q, R values, and this equation is nothing but Lagrange's linear equation. So we have to transform this equation of the form dx by capital P is equal to dy by capital Q is equal to dz by capital R. So I'll substitute the values of P, Q and R. What is capital P? Capital P is nothing but root x. So capital Q is nothing but root y, and R value is nothing but root z. So I got the three equations 1, 2 and 3. So if I can equate 1 and 2 equations, I'll get one solution, and if I can equate 2 and 3 equations, I'll get the another solution. See here, dx by root x is equal to dy by root y. Here dy by root y is equal to dz by root z. If I integrate on both sides, then it will be dz by root x is equal to integral dy by root y. So what is integral root x? So integral 1 by root x is nothing but 2 root x. So this is also 2 root y sum c1. So this is 2 root x minus 2 root y is equal to sum c1. If I take 2 common and send it to this constant, then it will be some other constant c1. So this is one solution. So if I see here, if I integrate dy by root y is equal to integral dz by root z. So 1 by root y is nothing but 2 root y is equal to 2 root z sum c2. If I bring to one side, then it will be 2 root y minus 2 root z is equal to c2. If I take 2 as common and send it to this constant, then this will be root y minus root z is equal to c2. So I got the second solution also. So after getting the two solutions, I can write the general solution as phi of root x minus root y comma root y minus root z is equal to some constant c. So this is very easy and very important also. So we have to pick P, Q and R values, and we have to transform this equation of this type. And again, after substituting P, Q and R values, so equating two equations, we'll get two solutions, and we have to write the general solutions as root x minus root y comma root y minus root z is equal to c. So this is how we have to solve and write really, and look forward you to practice thoroughly, and hopefully you will have a look at my upcoming videos on how to solve and how to use the multipliers to solve the Lagrange's linear differential equations. And if you like my video, please raise your thumb, subscribe to my channel, leave a comment below and share it to your friends, and feel free to leave a comment below. Thank you so much.